Now today what I am going to discuss, significant subject I am going to discuss, is not to mistake that it is exactly like when we sleep, we have a dream. This material world or material life is not like that. Then how is it? This we'll discuss today. How is it different? Before that, let us analyze what happens when we lie down and when we dream. We lie down, we close our eyes, we go out of the external consciousness. That means my senses, my body, my real eyes, real nose, real ears are all inactive. But I get into, my mind is active. Who is dreaming? Through my mind only I can dream. I am the dreamer. But I have got, you know, body, senses, mind, intelligence, all this I have. And they are all sleeping, except spiritual mind. Spiritual mind is also sleeping. Others are inactive, sleeping and inactive, whereas spiritual mind is sleeping but active in the sleep, in a dream. What is the dream? That is the I am creating a world for myself. In the case of lying on a bed and dreaming, you lie down, you create your own world. X, Y, Z, they create their own world. So one should not think that when our Vedas say that this material life is like a dream, that each of us are creating our own this material world, and then when you get self-realized, when you see the truth, the whole world vanishes. It doesn't exist. This is not what we are saying. This is not what the Vaishnava philosophy says. So then why we still call it a dream? We call it a dream. Yesterday also I explained. In this material world, the seed of illusion, around the seed of, the entire seed of illusion is, I am this material body. Mistaken identity. I am this material body. This is Maya's trick. This entire body is created and then it is animated by the Lord's presence in it. Immediately I identify this is me. And then not only I identify this is me, I look at the others and identify that they are them, they are that body. See, we are born as babies. Slowly we open our eyes. We see our own body. My hands, legs, I am able to move. And the baby sees that this body is under his will. He can move, he can move his legs, hands, everything. So it starts identifying that, oh, what I can move, oh, okay, what all I can move is me. Oh, then he sees other people, according to their will, they are able to move. Oh, so that is their body. That is them. I am this, that is them. So right from childhood, babyhood itself, our illusion begins, I am this body. But the truth is, you are not the body. Truth is what Krishna says. You are only seer of the body, but you think you are the body. So a web of relationship is developed, the common perception, everybody is in the, okay, material world, everybody is Kshetrajna, everybody is a soul. And en masse, everybody is believing that they are the body. And the body has its own, it's a duplication of our spiritual body. So it has got thinking, it can, with the help of the soul's presence, it can think, feel, will, everything. Like a perfect robot. It's called Yantra. This body is a, you can call it as physical, biological, psychological Yantra. It's Pakka Yantra it is. And Krishna says, when you understand and analyze it, I am the Kshetrajna, knower of the Yantra. But this Yantra is there. So when we say that in this material world we are in illusion, we do not say that the world outside is what I see with my eyes, what I touch, all these things. They are not illusion. They are manifestation, temporary manifestations of Krishna's external energy. And then we are Krishna's transcendental energy. The Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, para and apara shakti. So we are transcendental, means we are beyond this. The seer is not of this material world. The seer is seated in this body, Krishna describes. And that seers, all the seers that are sitting in the body, he says, they are all my jiva. All the jivas are my another kind of energy, superior energy. And all the bodies are inferior energy. So we sit in this inferior energy and we start thinking that this is my spiritual body. Because in the spiritual world, in your real body, it is spiritual body. It is not material body. It is not made up of matter. But here we are thinking this is spiritual body. Because our nature is to think, our nature is to have a body. Our nature is to have senses. Our nature is to have, you know, relationship with other people. I am the body, others are body. I have to have relationship with other people. The soul's basic instinct is Satchidananda. To think, to feel, to will, to love, to do, to see, touch, smell, taste, hear, etc. This is nature of the soul. That is why as soon as the soul leaves this body, the eyes cannot see, ears cannot hear. That means the property of seeing, touching, smelling, thinking, feeling, willing is belonging to the soul. The thinker, feeler, willer, toucher, all is the soul. Knower, doer, everything is a soul. At its spiritual level, it is spiritual plane only. Spirit can act only in spiritual plane. That is being translated into the material world and we are in. That is why it is called dream. That means the common thing that we can understand between the sleep when we lie on our bed and this is very simple. You are in another world than in your real world. Similarly, all the jivas are in a world which is not their real world. Because they are eternal. Their real world is eternal. Their real personality is eternal. Their interpersonal relationship of the souls are all eternal. Where is that experience? We don't have that experience in the material world. So each of us identify ourselves with this body. That means, I gave an example also. Yesterday, like Prabhupada is walking on this earth. He's self-realized. He's awakened. Awakened doesn't mean, you know, the world disappears. Awakened means he starts seeing that all the living entities are in illusion. They are suffering, having forgotten Krishna. They are all entitled to be in connection with Krishna and eternal love.